On Mars, there is a crater that bears the strange name of Jezero, a term that in several Balkan languages is used to indicate a lake region, and which is also the name of a very small town in Bosnia that rises near a lake where a small river flows. Just a case? Not really. For some years now, the International Astronomical Union has decided to name the most geologically or biologically interesting Martian craters under the name of small towns and villages on Earth. Thus, in 2007, the name of the Bosnian village was given to a 45-kilometer crater on the western edge of Isidis Planitia, a giant impact basin just north of the Martian equator. The logic of the choice lies in the fact that the crater in the past was also a lake full of water, and moreover a lake where an ancient and winding Martian river flowed. An environment where, according to NASA experts, ancient organic molecules and other potential signs of microbial life could have been preserved in the water and sediments that flowed in the crater billions of years ago. And it is precisely among those sediments where once the river water widened into swamps. February 18th next year, Perseverance, the new automatic robot launched last July 30th from Cape Canaveral, will settle down to finally give an important answer to the eternal question about the possibility that there was, or still is, life on Mars. Almost a decade of preparation, a ton of weight, 7 scientific instruments, a robotic arm, a support drone, 23 high-definition cameras, the first microphones ever brought to the Red Planet. The mission, which as a whole is called Mars 2020, is one of the most ambitious ever conceived by NASA in recent years. Reaching Mars is not easy, and getting something down on its surface is even more complicated, as space agencies who have tried so far know. The United States is in fact the only country to date to have successfully made controlled landings, bringing several rovers to Mars. The largest of them, Curiosity, is still active after its arrival in 2012 and is still collecting valuable information about the planet. The Spirit and Opportunity rovers have shown that liquid water once flowed on the surface of Mars. Curiosity discovered that 4 billion years ago, conditions on Mars were favorable for the development of life as we know it. Perseverance will look directly for signs of past life. At first glance, Perseverance seems to be a copy of Curiosity, both in size, 3 meters long by 2.7 meters wide, and shape, with its set of 6 wheels and characteristic turret with cameras and other sensors on top. Actually, as we are about to see, it is a heavily improvised version. There are, in fact, many different ways in which this mission will help pave the way for future human expeditions to Mars and demonstrate technologies that could also be used in the future. This includes, for example, testing a new method for producing oxygen from the Martian atmosphere, improving landing techniques, as well as analyzing the weather and other conditions that could affect other Mars missions. In fact, the rover will use the same technology used for self-driven cars on Earth. This is made possible by machine learning algorithms and sensors that allow you to cross difficult terrain. Going into more detail, 2 of the instruments, called Pixel and Sherlock, are located next to the drill on the turret of the robotic arm. They will scan the Martian rocks to determine their chemical composition and look for organic materials, providing key input into the ground team's decision on which rocks to drill. The rover also carries the SuperCam instrument, a complex suite of sensors, including a camera, laser, and spectrometers, designed to hit Martian rocks up to 6 meters away to measure their chemical and mineral composition, with the ability to identify organic molecules. The instruments mounted inside the rover's main body include MOXIE, which will demonstrate the ability to extract oxygen from carbon dioxide in Mars's atmosphere, and RIMFAX, a radar that will study the planet's underground geological structure. The mission also carries a weather station and 23 cameras, the most used in a deep space mission ever, including the first camera on Mars with zoom function. That camera system, located at the top of a Perseverance tree, will rise after landing. It's called Mastcam-Z and will record video and 360-degree views. But at what point is the mission unfolding? Where is the probe now? After traveling for over 6 months at a speed of over 88,000 kilometers per hour, on December 8th, the Mars 2020 has now completed 70% of its journey and was heading to Mars, still 142 million kilometers away. About 10 minutes before reaching the upper layers of the atmosphere, around 8 p.m. on February 18th, the spacecraft will begin to slow down and prepare for descent, protected by a heat shield of 4.5 meters in diameter. The speed will drop to 1,600 kilometers per hour, and small thrusters will adjust the angle of descent, allowing the probe to start navigating towards the landing site. About 4 minutes later, at an altitude of about 11 kilometers, a sensor will choose the right time to deploy a 21.5 meter diameter parachute. After another 20 seconds, the heat shield at the bottom of the spacecraft will lower, allowing a downward-facing guidance radar and cameras to begin to see the Martian surface. Mars's atmosphere is much thinner than Earth's, so a parachute alone will not slow the spacecraft down enough for a safe landing. So, after abandoning the shield and parachute at about 2 kilometers of altitude, 8 thrusters will further slow the rover's descent. From 300 kilometers per hour at a speed close to zero and only 20 meters from the surface. Finally, 7.6 meter long nylon cables will power Perseverance to the surface using a technique called sky crane, already successfully tested during the landing of Curiosity in 2012. As soon as the 6 wheels of the rover touch down, the cables will be broken and the descent module will fly away to crash at a safe distance. During the landing, several cameras will be active, which will allow for the first time to follow live each of its phases. A pair of microphones will also be present to collect environmental sounds, as well as those produced by the instruments. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell. You will help us to make products of even higher quality. With the rover firmly on the ground, one of its first tasks will be to get out from under the Ingenuity drone and place it on the surface, then moving away to a distance of at least 100 meters before the helicopter takes flight. Ingenuity, weighing 1.8 kilograms and powered by solar energy, will fly autonomously, obviously, without the possibility of real-time guidance by ground controllers. In at least 30 days, it will make 5 flights up to distances of 200 meters. Filming the area with 2 high-definition cameras from a maximum height of 10 meters. However, flying a drone over Mars will be a real challenge due to the harsh climate and rarefied air. In fact, the density of Mars's atmosphere is about 1% of Earth's, which will force the 1.2-meter diameter rotors to spin about 10 times faster than those of a drone flying over Earth. The data acquired during these flight tests will help the next generation of Martian helicopters to give an aerial dimension to Mars explorations, with scouting functions for rovers and human crews, transport of small payloads, or surveys of hard-to-reach destinations. Reached Jezero, Perseverance will search for molecular fossils, i.e. structures and minerals due to the presence of possible microorganisms. In order to track ancient microbes on Earth, geobiologists look for structures and rock formations that could have been formed only by biological processes. Like stromatolites, for example, fossilized algae that shape sediments into a wavy pattern visible to the naked eye. Likewise, the Sherlock tool from Perseverance will do on Mars. Mounted on the robotic arm, Sherlock is an ultraviolet spectrometer accompanied by a camera for searching for organic and mineral compounds that have been contaminated in aqueous environments with traces of microbial life. In short, although not really hunting for live organisms, this time we will search for any traces of past life, something that previous missions were absolutely not equipped to do. With the exception of the 2 Viking landers of 1976, in fact, none of them carried the appropriate instrumentation for the detection of life, neither past nor present. With all this, although Mars 2020 is considered a more active mission than the others on the biological front, NASA insists not to overcharge on the topic of life, as there were the fear of exposing oneself to disappointments, which would immediately lead to a reduction in funding. For one other purpose, Adam Seltzner, chief engineer of the Mars 2020 mission, should in fact make public statements such as, "We are not a life-detecting mission. We are only looking for signs of past life on the surface of Mars." This strategy is really not very comprehensible. What is the use of continuing to spend billions to send robots to Mars in search of past life? Wouldn't it be better to try to find out once and for all if there is a present life? It seems that even with perseverance, NASA is trying in every way to prolong to the edge of a suspense that has lasted for 50 years. It really comes to think so. It also makes you wonder the meaning of the second most important task of the rover in this mission, that of the samples to bring back to Earth. The intent appears completely shareable. For the first time, if everything goes according to plan, scientists will be able to analyze Martian rock samples directly in modern laboratories on Earth. And this would obviously be a huge opportunity for planetary research. Once on our planet, in fact, the collected samples could be analyzed with instruments much more precise and refined than those that can be placed on a rover. The analysis would make it possible to study the dust grains in great detail, making it easier to identify traces of life as fossils of unicellular organisms. But how would all this be done? And with what timescale? In practice, Perseverance will have to fill 43 titanium tubes in which the samples will be stored by digging rocks and sediments with a drill placed on the robotic arm. The mission requires at least 20 of them to be collected, although the researchers are confident that they will be able to fill all 43. Once the collection is complete, the idea is to leave the containers somewhere on Martian soil. It is not yet clear if the precious cargo will be deposited in one place or if it will be decided to create two separate deposits, so you have a spare mini warehouse if anything goes wrong. At this point in the story, it is quite natural to ask, when and who will come to take the samples to bring them back to Earth? And to this question, NASA answers like this. The return mission of the samples will start with the launch from Earth of the so-called Fetch Rover, which will land in the same site of Perseverance and collect the tubes. A small rocket on board called Mars Ascent Vehicle will then take them into low Martian orbit, where we'll find a European probe that will then take them back to Earth. And all this not in 6 months or a year, but in 2031, in 11 years. This means only one thing. Until that date, NASA will renounce descent to Mars missions able to verify on the spot the existence of present life. Not to mention the fact that by 2030 we are, or were, even thinking about sending a human mission to Mars. In short, really incomprehensible the policy of NASA, if not in the light of a corporate will, all aimed at diluting over time a suspense at the bottom of which there is a certain pessimism about the possibility that on Mars there was or there really is life. In any case, apart from the controversy, Perseverance mission will be extraordinary from a technological and media point of view. All phases will be transmitted in live streaming, and each of its topical moments will be seen with a big screen resolution. A show, or if you prefer, a blockbuster of which only in 2031 will we know the ending.